Next week on Me in Mexico.
Action.
Previously on Me in Mexico.
Oh, she's so cute.
I'm promoting fun. I mean, like, I'm not beat. I don't have a glam spot.
Why do you have these glasses on? It's dark outside.
Because I got LASIK surgery. You crack me up. We're doing an experiment where you are putting together a reality show.
In this format.
It's starting here. Right now, working title is Me in Mexico.
Yes, she cute. She getting washed up. She says that this song is me. I don't even know this song.
Maria.
It's just you and this really nice sunset.
It's just me and Mexico.
The palm trees.
It's called. You've been drinking like watermelon and water vodka. Cheers. I have rest.
Yeah, you.
She be getting it. These are the side crunches. Crunch it. Crunch it. Crunch.
Some abs. Down the game. Where did you go?
Hot pink over here.
Getting up there to get the shot. And action. You're the last of the
still
good.
Holding on.
You
last of the Mohicans. I like that little house so much.
It's so cute. Look at the colors.
Give me our kids, it's Mother's Day!
I
got a bag!
Just kiss on the cheek for everything I do.
I'm sorry, they yelled at you before.
Please take off the
cheek. Please?
Chain.
This time I'll help you, I promise.
Tiberius.
Needed break, okay? It is exhausting playing a slutty elf.
Get back here!
Santa passed out in his own vomit and probably crapped his pants. And until the mall can find a replacement, we need you to come back and play Mrs. Claus.
No, you play Mrs. Claus, Lady Hummel. You were born to play Mrs. Claus and Mrs. Butterworth and B. Arthur and Barbara Bush.
The mob is getting restless out there.
Oh my God, we are begging you, please come here and help us.
His first NFL touchdown. Michael Rivera,
please. You guys love me. I keep it real, and I'm hilarious.
Excellent.
Hold up, Private Puckerman. I'm gonna let you finish, but first I would like to uphold the tradition of hijacking this glee club and making everyone sit through what is basically an intervention. Mr. Shue, you said that we could read you some of our favorite numbers, right? Well, then I want to do a dance duet with Brittany. Hit it.
You're so damn hard to please.
We gotta kill the switch.
You're from the 70s.
But I'm a 90s bitch.
I don't care.
I love it.
We're monsters!
Are they going to ask me to sing the national anthem next time?
I was
that so many times in India.
Take Josie. He loves it and he's really good at it. But I got homework from singing lessons and I decided to let you guys in on it. So let me know what you think. I know you will.
Anyways.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me, and I'm feeling good.
When I was a little girl,
You got a phone for do the Miley.
I'm doing
do
the Miley.
The Miley.
Why do you consider home, Naya?
Fox. What was your childhood dream job?
Being on Glee.
Oh. When you're feeling down, what song cheers you up?
Love on Top, Beyonce. That's a good one. How many times were you grounded by your parents?
So many. I'm still grounded. Right now. You're the next So You Think You Can Dance contestant. Which dance style will let your skills shine?
Twerking.
Can you show us?
No.
Come on.
Not right
now. We're in the Fox Lounge. This is a safe space.
It's not a safe space.
Thanks for joining us. Check out Glee on Fox.
Go.
To you don't wanna bring arms out. I've got so many clothes I keep some in my aunt's house. Disturbing London, baby, we about to branch out. Soon I'll be the king like Prince Charles, Charles. Yeah, yeah, and there ain't nobody fresher. Semester to semester, raving with the freshers. 20 light bulbs around my table and my dresser. CLC compressor, just in case that don't impress her. Say hello to Dexter, say hello to Uncle Fest. I got them gazing at my necklace and my crazy sun protectors. G-Shocks, I got a crazy dumb collection. Haters, I can't yeah, yeah, we bring the stars out. We bring the women and the cars out. Let's have a toast to celebration, get a glass out. And we can do this until...
Oh, Kurt, can I have a word with you?
Oh, I'm gonna go.
No.
You know, Ralph, stay. Kurt, I took what you said to heart, and I thought long and hard about it, and it occurred to me that you may have a point. Okay, maybe Brittany and I are too young to get married. I mean, after all, that's... why it didn't work out with you and Blaine, right? Or maybe it didn't work out because you're a judgmental little geronophile with a mouth like a cat's ass. Maybe Blaine got tired of hearing a shrill, self-aggrandizing lecture about how you felt the two of you were at the very apex of the gay rights movement every time you so much as cooked macaroni and cheese together or farted. Maybe Blaine didn't want to be with someone who looks like they just removed their top row of dentures every time they smile, or someone who doesn't dress like an extra out of one of Andy Dick's more elaborate wet dreams. Maybe Blaine grew weary of dating a breathier, more feminine Quinn Fabray. Maybe he finally got freaked out by your strange obsession with old people that causes you to skulk around nursing homes like one of those cats that can smell cancer. Maybe he got tired of watching you drape yourself on every piano you happen past to entertain exactly no one with, say, some song that Judy Garland choked on her tongue in the middle of, or some sassy old Broadway standard made famous by another dead alcoholic crump. Maybe Blaine woke up one day and said, you know what? I don't want to marry a sexless, self-centered baton twirler. Maybe I need someone who knows more than three dance moves. The finger wag, the shoulder shimmy, and the one where you pretend to twirl two invisible rainbow-colored ribbons attached to your hips. So you know what? Maybe that's why it didn't work out. Maybe it has nothing to do with me and Brittany. Maybe it's just that you are utterly, utterly intolerable. Maybe that has something to do with it.
Merry Christmas! Yeah. Who's ready to sit on my lap?
What would you like for Christmas?
I want a Dot McStuffins Time for your checkup doll.
Mm. Oh,
so cute.
Well, that sounds a little molesty. I mean, I didn't start playing doctor till I was 9. We'll see what I can do.
I think that somebody needs to freeze the fat for Christmas because somebody weighs more than Mrs. Claus.
Oh, whoa, stop right there. You look a little Jewish, right, Rachel?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Bye. I think he pooped in his pants.
I want a Kinder College Warning laptop.
Why don't we just get you an iPad? You can't even get porn on whatever you just asked me for, okay?
how's it going?
You look exactly like a young Britney S. Pierce, doesn't she?
Britney is my ex-girlfriend, and she just dumped me, which is why I'm even here and why I have this job. And we're lesbians, you know? And, like, I'd never
okay,
been...
Okay, great job.
What would you like for Christmas? Oh, nope. You know what? I think that you should ask Santa to get your daddy a job with some dental benefits because your grill is freaking jacked up. Do you see? I think that Mrs. Claus needs a break. This is going well, right?
That bitch is pure evil.
I think she's sweet.
Really? Well, then why is she giving my girl laxatives?
Why are you going through my back?
It's all part of being a mentor. What is this? Hmm? And don't tell me it's because the cafeteria food binds you up.
Those are, like, from months ago. I forgot they were even in there.
Your pretty little liar gave them to her. I can sense it, thanks to my psychic Mexican third eye. See,
this is what my psych professor calls projecting. You're projecting Kitty onto me. Santana, we've graduated. It's really time to get over this.
Get over what?
You being jealous of me.
And why would I be jealous of you? And please don't tell me it's because you're in some lame secret Nazi sorority.
Look, homecoming weekend, I went to Jodie Foster's clam bake. And that professor that I was talking about, well, he's 35, smokes a pipe. Well, he's divorcing his wife, who hasn't touched him for 3 years. And I'm dating him.
Wow, Twitter update! Quinn is all excited about another guy defining her life.
And what are you excited about? Shaking pom-poms in Kentucky? I mean, you want everybody to think that you're such a badass, but really, you're just a scared little girl with low self-esteem who's too frightened to chase her dreams.
Did Professor Patches teach you that one in between quickies on his office couch? Does he get so turned on by teen moms who barely visit their kid? Oh, what are you guys doing?
Nothing. Nothing at all.
Quinn always was a genius slapper. Excuse me, Schuster. Before we cast another pointless vote in a meaningless contest that has absolutely no practical ramifications whatsoever, I would like to say some words about my good friend Rachel Berry. Rachel Berry is the most horrible human being on the planet. What? Can it, troll?
Santana.
You have sold half the people in this room down the river more times than I can count so that you can get a solo or the lead in a musical. And I'm pretty sure that you don't know the names of the other half of the people.
That's not true.
All right, what is his name?
Rick.
Exactly. Thank you. See, you've all met Rachel, okay, but I live with her. Let me tell you what it's like to share a bathroom with this stubby, undergrown little cretin. Someone in that apartment shaves their face and leaves their stubble in the sink, and we all know it ain't Kurt, so do the math.
That's a lie.
You know what else is a lie? When you won prom queen.
What?
Yeah, that's right. You didn't win, okay? Everybody just felt really bad for you, and the two people that you hate most in this whole world, Quinn and I, stuffed the ballot box so that you would win.
You're so cruel, Santana. You're only doing this to me because I'm the lead of Funny Girl and you're just the lowly understudy. You want to make me feel bad because I'm better than you and you're an awful person.
Well, I feel so much better. Let's vote. You did this to me. You told Coach Devastra about my summer surgery.
You have a surgery when you get your appendix out. You got a boob job.
Yep, sure did.
You can't hit me.
Well, sure I can, unless you got yourself knocked up again, slut.
Stop the violence.
Hey, hey, what is this? What happened to Mrs. Beta family? Hey.
Oh, please. She has a family. She's a mother. Walk away and tighten up your body before you get to class.
What's that?
It's a receipt. I went to Jared. You can reimburse me. We'll have dinner at Breadsticks, and then we can consider this settled.
No. And consider what settled?
Look, you made your point. I'm sort of a bitch, but I'm willing to change. I won't tell Lauren to look out for poachers who might mistake her for the endangered white rhino.
I heard that. Don't make me rip that weave out your head.
Oh, this is not gonna be good.
Hello, Lauren. You are a beautiful person. Now get out of my way, please, afore I end you.
You don't want to push me.
Oh, but see, I sort of do. I'm from a part of town called Lima Heights adjacent. You know where that is, poppin' fresh? It's on the wrong side of the tracks.
Thank you.
get going.
Yeah, that's how we do it in Lima Heights.
Get you to the nurse.
Talking about me?
No, why would you think that?
Why did you audition without telling me?
Well, because I figured that we were going to fight about it anyway, so we might as well go at it afterwards. That way you don't have a chance to torpedo me.
Fanny Bryce is a New York Jew. You playing that role is like me being the Grand Marshal of the Puerto Rican Day Parade.
But if you weren't playing Fanny, if you weren't playing the lead and I came home and said that I auditioned to be the understudy, would you still feel so strongly?
I'm arguing on principle. This is not personal.
Bull crap. Rachel, you have all of this talk about forgiveness for high school, but the reality is that you just love having something over me. I mean, these past couple of months with you in rehearsal and me waiting tables has been such sweet revenge for you, and you just can't stand the idea that I might get mine too.
I just got you on the cover of New York Magazine.
In the background. You were practically glowing about it.
That's because I accomplished something. It had nothing to do with you.
No, see, it actually has everything to do with me. Every step that you take in this city is fueled by all of the hate that we gave you. All of that ambition is just you trying to prove us wrong, which is fine, Rachel. I mean, whatever works for you, just don't try to say that it isn't.
Okay, wait, just chill for a second, please. Okay, I'll make espresso.
You know what? You can't handle it. You can't handle that. I have made it, and you are just begging to be my understudy.
Okay, you know what? Just admit that even with all of your years of singing lessons and dancing lessons and only child adoration from your gay Broadway dads, that I am just as good as you. Unlike you, I can be popular in high school and still make it big after graduation. Just admit that no matter what you do or how far you go, you will never be able to scratch that itch. You will never be able to look down on me and redeem yourself, because I was better than you then, and I'm always going to be better than you. You are short, you are awful, and that is never going to change.
I think you should move out.
I agree.
This is crazy. We're friends.
Not really. Hello? Yeah, good. Okay, well, thank you for letting me know so soon. Bye. I'll see you at rehearsals, Barry. I'm your new understudy.